Hey guys, Ricky Widmer here from Most Valuable Podcast. You're about to listen to a little bit of our primetime podcast that we recorded this week. Make sure to go to blogtalkradio.com/Most Valuable Podcast for our full-length podcast that you can go ahead and download. I hope you enjoy it. I know me and Brandon did recording it.
This podcast is brought to you by Most Valuable Podcasts, leading the league in podcasting entertainment.
What's up, everybody? Ricky Widmer here, along with the one, the only, Brandon Swanny Swanson.
Hey.
And welcome into another edition of the Primetime Podcast here on Most Valuable Podcast. And Brandon, we got a jam-packed show. We are talking about, basically, it's almost a 2018 NFL draft show, but mostly about some of the big players that we're going to see this year. Two are quarterbacks, one's a wide receiver. We're going to look at Josh Rosen. So you're going to have to prove some doubters wrong, because apparently an NFL exec says he is a total mess off the field. We're going to look at Josh Allen. Could he be the number one pick over a Sam Darnold next season? And then we're going to look at Minnesota with new head coach PJ Fleck, and could his big wide receiver Rashad still be this year's Corey Davis? But Brandon, I want to get right into it. This is a quarterback we have talked ad nauseum about coming into this season, and that is Josh Rosen. Coming in, we've talked about how this is going to be the year of a quarterback. You've got Baker Mayfield, Mason Rudolph, Lamar Jackson. You got Sam Darnold. You got Josh Allen. You've got Swirly over in Penn State. There are a ton of guys. Jake Browning in Washington as well. There are numerous guys at the quarterback position this year. And it comes out that an NFL scout and executive told the Monday morning quarterback that not only is Josh Rosen have a ton of issues, but he is, and I quote, a mess off the field. Brandon, I'm going to throw it to you first like I always do. Is this going to be the year where Josh Rosen has to prove his doubters wrong and prove and say, there's nothing to see here, I'm a good guy, I have no messes off the field?
You know, Ricky, I don't really know about any of his off-the-field stuff. I haven't heard any off-the-field issues for Josh Rosen. I don't know. Maybe you have. Maybe you've got articles on it. Mm-hmm. But I don't. I haven't heard of anything about him off the field, not in the news or anything like that. I've only heard of what he's done or has not done on the field. I think you're a little late. If you're Josh Rosen, I think you're too late on this one. You had a pretty good freshman year. And then you get hurt in your sophomore year. If you do well this year, that's great, but I still don't think that's not going to thrust you up into the top of the quarterback discussion. It's not going to. And, you know, again, not everything has been his fault. You know, he gets the injury in year two, you know, not his fault. His offensive line did nothing for him. The year that I look at is his freshman year. He completes 60% of his passes, throws for almost 3,700 yards. He has 23 touchdowns, 11 interceptions, 55th nationally in passer rating. You know, there were things, obviously, that you're going to see as a freshman. You're just going to see that's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
But he looked like a guy who was, he's going to break out next year. He's going to break out. And unfortunately, he just got broke. This is a last chance for Rosen to prove anything on the field, off the field, anything. And I don't know if he's going to be able to do it, because I think what we've seen from Josh Rosen was, Ricky, my question was his peak his freshman year?
And that's the big thing. That's what I look at, is when you hit that big freshman year, and we're thinking, okay, that, like you said, that sophomore year, he's going to build on it, and he falls back. You kind of get worried a little bit, and you go, okay, did he hit that peak? Is this one of those things where he hit it right away, or was it coming in from high school really determined to work, and then as college life kind of took over, did we see a little bit of that come into play? And the thing that I'm looking at here is, you mentioned it at the beginning. I haven't heard anything outright in the news of specific incidents that Josh Rosen has had. And I'm looking at thebiglead.com, and they mention it's kind of as a joke. And I'm going to read this little snippet that they got. and they say the phrases tons of issues and mess off the field suggest a growing narrative. It's always difficult to assess the validity of these claims without knowing what they are based off of or the availability of any specific. We do know that Rosen had a hot tub in his room, but had it removed. He cares not for university house code, apparently. And that's a picture of Rosen in an inflatable pool filled with water in his dorm room. So to me, I look at this and go, is this the NFL exec and scout that said this about Rosen? Is this have to do with something we don't know? Or is it one of those things where in their mind as a scout and an executive, they go, you know what? I'm going to stay away from him because maybe it's an immaturity thing. It brings up to me what we saw with Connor Cook, especially later on. There were NFL scouts and executives questioning his maturity. Are we going to get that through this year? And that's why this junior year has to be the breakout season for Josh Rosen. So that we look back after this year, and the question you asked me of, hey, was his freshman year his peak? We need to look back after it and go, no. It wasn't, because the junior year was even better than the freshman year. But he's going to have a lot to work on.
I think that another thing is that it's, you know, I mentioned before that it's not all Josh Rosen's fault, and it's not. I mean, he saw so many people fall around him.
Mm-hmm.
Kennedy Polamalu, running backs coach, fired after 1 year. Offensive line coach Adrian Clem, fired. Tui Asosopo, quarterbacks coach, leaves for Cal. Receivers coach Eric Yarber leaves for the Los Angeles Rams. All these guys were gone. Gone. I mean, he didn't have much time to work with them. This almost, to me, seems a little small comparison to Alex Smith in the NFL with the 49ers. He is not the top talent. You don't think of top talent, think Alex Smith.
Mm-hmm.
But when you think of an embattled quarterback, a guy who, this again, when he's with the 49ers, a guy who has gone through so much turnover and change and can't have any consistency. And one guy comes in with a system over here on the left. Another guy comes in, he's got a system over here on the right. You cannot. It is very hard. Whether you're a quarterback in the NFL, whether you're a quarterback in college, high school, it doesn't matter. You have all this change and transition around you to keep up with that and feel comfortable in that system and get comfortable in that system and then change the entire playbook to something completely different is difficult. And for him to have all this around him and then just fall and leave, that's also a difficult position to be in. So it's not all on him, but I think a lot of it is that you're a leader. You're a quarterback, you're a leader, you are the number one kind of on that team. That's mm-hmm. what people are looking at. They look at the quarterback, especially in college. I think that that's a big position. You're always looking at it. He needs to step up. He needs to be more of a leader. He needs to be a bit more mature. I personally think a blow-up a hot tub in your room, that's hilarious to me. That doesn't bother me a bit. But I think that what he needs to do is he really needs to be able to perform on the field. You've got to be able to perform on the field to be able to have that much fun off. And I think that for him, and now this last year, and now what has happened this last year in UCLA?
Mm-hmm.
What's happened, Ricky? We've had Lonzo Ball in basketball. We've had LeVar Ball in basketball. Most people would wish they don't have LeVar Ball in basketball.
$500 pair of shoes, man.
Yeah,
MJ couldn't.
I was gonna say he doesn't think that MJ could sell it for that much. No, because MJ would sell it for $1,000 and people would still buy it, you dumb ass. But I think that now that they've had Lonzo Ball for this year, they only had him for one.
Mm-hmm.
But the fact that that brought all that attention to UCLA, you don't think
now
that Josh Rosen doesn't want to try and bring the same thing in his final year to UCLA? He's hungry. He's got to be. You know, it's all on UCLA basketball. He's got to want to put UCLA football back on the map. I feel like it hasn't been since 2010, 2011, since UCLA football has been on the map when I think they went 10-4 mm-hmm. or something like that, 10-3 maybe. But this team, they need to gel. And will they be able to? We will see.
We've got Jed Fish, new coordinator. Hopefully he's going to be able to bring the guys together and gel them. It has not been easy. And Jim Mora, you know, he's in there trying to do his best. But it hasn't been easy. His coordinators have not proved to be as good as he had hoped.
Well, and I like how you bring up the Lonzo Ball thing, because Josh Rosen and Lonzo Ball have something in common. Lonzo came to the team. He was the kid from Chino Hills, hometown kid, gonna put UCLA back on the map, and he did, especially with how bad UCLA was the year before. They had Lonzo Ball in college basketball, but Josh Rosen's the same kid from Manhattan Beach, about, what, an hour, if you get good traffic, an hour southwest of L.A., and that's what Rosen needs. And the one thing that I can't help but think is, when we see terms like tons of issues and a mess off the field, we automatically think the worst. We think like the Jaron Conley, we think of the off the field with like Joe Mixon. That's where our mind goes. The Ray Rices, there's numerous other ones. Those off the field issues, the Josh Gordons even, that's what we think about. Maybe the scouts and execs that are saying this, what else could be considered off the field? The field is just where you play the game. Off the field could be how he's going to be in the quarterback room, how he's going to be leading your team in the locker room, how he's going to be as a kind of mentor, not a mentor, that's not the word I'm looking for. The word is a presence in your team facility, on your team, and these can go to that, because the team facility is not on the field. It's technically off the field. So when I look at these comments, they're not talking about, oh, he's getting in trouble here, getting in trouble there. I think that these scouts and execs are looking at Josh Rosen and saying, I don't think you have what it takes to lead a team. I do not think you have what it takes to be a competent quarterback in the NFL, because the one position that we look at to be smarter than everybody else, to be a little bit more cognitive than everybody else, is the quarterback position. I'm going to use an example of a guy I love to listen to daily when I get the chance, is Colin Cowherd.
You like him?
And I love Colin Cowherd.
Didn't know that.
I know. But the thing that I look at, I love Colin Cowherd. Everyone should know that. But I know you're joking, by the way. When we were talking about the Wunderlich test, he was talking about it, and guys like Myles Garrett and Jadeveon Clowney and J.J. Watt, he said, I don't care what they score. Can they get to the quarterback? Okay, cool. However, a quarterback, okay, what's his Wunderlich score? I'm curious a little bit more, he said, about that QB Wunderlich score, because we want our quarterback to be a little bit smarter,
Ricky,
than everyone else.
Please, for the viewers out there that may not know what the Wunderlich score is,
the Wunderlich,
please
is,
explain it.
It's a test that prospects take going into the NFL draft. That kind of it's kind of like a ACT on steroids kind of a thing for college prospects going into the NFL draft. And you get a score, and it basically tells you how smart you are. And basically, Cowherd was like, that quarterback's the only position I want to know what that score is, because they're the position that we want to be a little bit smarter. They have to recognize more things. They got to be thinking about more things. So when I see tons of issues and mess off the field, I think these execs and scouts are looking more for off the field, meaning the preparation of the game and the team facility, not necessarily getting in trouble in bars and outside in the real world.
I agree with you. I think that's very important. And I think that you make a really good point in saying that it doesn't necessarily have to be something drastic off the field, like a rape charge or a sexual assault charge or this or that. You're right. I think that it could be something as simple as someone saying, okay, you know, I don't feel like he's a very good leader. He doesn't seem mature. He doesn't seem like he would be able to be the guy that steps up and says to his team, guys, are you with me or are you not with me? Because if you're not, you got to step aside, you know? Mm-hmm. And it kind of like one of those. And I think that it's very important to make sure that you have that guy and that he is that guy if you're going to be the one taking the chance on him, or not so much taking the chance on him, but taking that pick. And I guess really any pick in the draft that you're taking a chance, really. I mean, you know what a guy has done, what he could do, but will he do it? Mm-hmm. Jamarcus Russell. So many of those guys, you know, that they didn't pan out.
Ryan Leaf. I mean, look at the entire story that we have with Ryan Leaf and kind of his chronologic story from being drafted to now.
Really tough, but really happy in the spot that he's in right now. Which he's very happy and everything like that. But you're right. But I don't think that you're not going to see whatever, unless on the other side, it just terribly goes downhill.
Mm-hmm.
But whatever Allen does this year, he's not going to surpass Sam Darnold. He's not going to be someone that a team looks at and goes, oh, Darnold or Rosen? Gosh, we got to go Rosen. I don't think that's going to happen.
No, it's not.
It's not. He can get to a point where you're looking at, okay, can he go early second round?
You think that? That's where it's going to be?
Well, come on. Look at what he's done.
Okay.
He's had 1 year where he's really, truly proven to be a solid quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
Would you not be worried that his health is something that could scare teams? Would you not be worried about that? Because that's his number one thing. He has to stay healthy. Can he do it?
I would I'm talking mock draft world, not what actually happened in the draft, because I think guys like Patrick Mahomes went way too high than what they should have gone. But right now, I know it's way too early. Way too early. And I'm going to be putting out a way too early mock draft soon for you guys. The thing that I think about is Josh Rosen to me, like around pick 24, that would be a good range for him right now. And of course, we've got this junior season for him to prove us a little bit more. I'm looking at the touchdown numbers for sure. 23 his freshman year, down to 10 his sophomore year.
But again, he didn't have a full season.
He didn't have a full season. But the thing that I look at right now is just based on quarterbacks. You're right. Sam Darnold is right now the early favorite. There's only one guy that can challenge him in my mind, and we're going to talk about him next in Josh Allen at Wyoming. It's those two at the top. Then for me, it's the highest that Josh Rosen can get, maybe 3 or 4, and then the lowest is probably early second. So the range would be like early second, but the highest he can get on a good junior season is the third quarterback taken off the board, because right now, and it depends on how all these guys do this year, but right now my top five quarterbacks heading into this year would be most likely Darnold, Allen, then Lamar Jackson, then Rosen, then Baker Mayfield. And that's where he's at right now. And right now I have him as the fourth best quarterback coming in. But that is me being also a little optimistic of that he's going to be better than a Baker Mayfield, better than a Mason Rudolph, and really the guy I think he's going to be battling with all season and jockeying for position is Lamar Action Jackson. That's going to be the guy that he jocks with this season. But Brandon, we're going to end this topic. Before we do, though, any final thoughts on Josh Rosen and how he can prove doubters wrong in his junior year?
Well, he's just got to have one hell of a year. That's what he's got to do. And I don't know if he's going to be able to do it. Based on what we've seen, again, you know, we got a really good freshman year. We got a, injury plagued sophomore year. And now we've got to see what he can do here in his junior year, which will, you know, undoubtedly be his final one.
Well, and this is where you guys come in. Let us know down below in the comment section. What do you guys think? Do you think Josh Rosen will be a good pro in the NFL? Do you think he needs to prove doubters wrong? And what do you think about the NFL scouts and execs that told the Monday morning quarterback that he has tons of issues and is a mess off the field? Let us know down below in the comment section. Well, thank you guys for checking out this video from the Primetime Podcast. If you want to check out more, click right over here. The video's right over here. Check it out. Check it out.